Hey, hi everyone, this is Vidya here. So, are you all done with the test cases? Yes? Let me just open up the SRS. Okay, so here it is. Urmila, is this your first session? Okay, for Manju also this is the first session. No, actually this is not an intro session. We are in the middle of the things. Okay, so in the last session, since you people were not there, so I just told the rest of them, I have given the SRS, that is the system requirement specification, and the assignment was given to complete the test cases onto that. Okay. I don't know, but this is not an intro session. How you get it for the intro? I don't know. I'm sorry for that. Okay. Yeah, Omila, you just attended the demo session. I mean, okay. Yesterday, did you attended it? Then. Okay, I can see some more over here, like Anu Sood Rukma. These people are also Rukma and Anu Sood. You're also attending the batch for the first time, is it so? And Shweta, yes, I know. I have I have put everybody on mute. Okay, so do you want to have a conversation with me? Then I can unmute you. The reason is, yeah, I would just unmute you. See, the reason is very simple. There are some many background noises which are going on, so just to avoid all those things. Let me unmute you, Anu. Anu?
Yeah, hi ma'am. Actually, I got a link in my email that this is a demo session for QA.
No, we had the demo session yesterday. This is going to
But
get.
I got the link, I think 2 or 3 hours before.
No, I mean, this is not the demo session though. But
But the link says it is a demo session.
okay. Listen to me. What you can do is, you can attend the session. There is no boundation. I won't say to leave the session. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, you can attend the session. But today we would be discussing the test cases that I have already given.
Okay.
We will be discussing on to that, so you can attend. I don't have any problem in that. Okay.
Okay, thank you so much.
Okay, let me get back to you people in a minute. Okay. Just hold on for a minute. Sorry for that. Just had an important call. Okay, so for Urmila, Deepak, and Anu, like whosoever are new over here in the batch, see, we are actually doing the continuation of the batch. Okay, some intro sessions are completed for the batch up till now. So in the last session, the students who were already present over here, I have given the SRS to them and they were asked to write down the test cases. So for today in this batch, we would be discussing the test cases. Okay, what all they have written. So I would be reviewing the test cases. So you can stay in the batch and can see that how it goes. Okay, so I don't have any problem in that. Okay. Okay, so for those to whom I have given the SRS in the last session and the test case template, were you able to do that, the test cases? Okay, and if so, can we like review some of the test cases if you want me to review for it you? Okay, so we can review some other test cases. So who would like to start with the things? Tasneem, you want to start the things? Okay, so So can you mail me your test cases so I can open it over here and can review it? And others also who want me to review the test cases, just mail it to me. Yes, Kumar, I got your test cases, but I told you earlier also that we would be reviewing it over here in the batch only, okay? So let me just open your test cases. By the time others, you can also mail me the test cases. You know my mail ID, that is vidya.bhagyatech@gmail.com, okay? Okay, so these are your test cases. Yes, Kumar. Manju, yes, you would be able to do it because we would be providing you with the recorded links. Okay, the sessions that are already completed, we have recorded those sessions. Okay, and have shared the links with the people who are already in the batch. Okay, so in the case that if they want to revise some of the things. So if you are also like if you are a new admission in the batch, so we can provide you with the recorded links, and also we would be taking some cover-up sessions also. Okay. So about the cover-up sessions and the recorded links, you need to talk to Raghu. He is the person who is managing all this stuff. Okay. Kathy, my mail ID is vidya.bhagyatech@gmail.com. Like we have covered some six sessions, I guess. Okay, so Shweta, what are you asking for? Like, I could not understand. You wanted to send it now? Yes, the test cases, the persons who have written it. Okay. Since you were not present in the batch, so you must have not written it. Okay, so you can send it to me. For this batch, just like for this session, just listen to the things so you would be able to match up with the things that what we are trying to do over here. Okay. Manju, total 45 days. The course duration you are asking about? Yes, that is between 1.5 to 2 months, and we are not having regular batches like every day. We are having on 3 days a week. Okay, so let us start with Kumar's test case, which is over here. Kumar, only 3 test cases you have written. What about the others? And also, why that ID has started with TC_03? Why not with 01? What happened to 1 and 2? Yes, Kumar. Let me unmute you so that you can answer to the things. Yeah, I would just unmute you. Tasneem, yes, I have got your mail, but let me first finish up with Kumar's test cases, okay, and then I'll get back to you. Okay, see, the people who are new to the batch, you are like, that is pretty obvious that you want to know each and everything. So can we make it like for now, you people can just listen to the batch, okay, whatever I'm saying, okay, and then after that, like after I have done the review of the test cases for these people, then you can be there, okay, while the others can drop off. So you new people can be there, and then I can answer your questions. So isn't that a good idea? Okay, because anyways you are going to be here for this batch, okay, and the people who are waiting already, who have done their course up till this point, I don't want them to mess up with the things. So those people, they can log off after the class, and you people can remain and can answer your questions. Okay, thank you everyone, thank you for your cooperation. Okay, Kumar, let me unmute you. Kumar,
I'm sorry, I did only three because I, for my personal reasons, I was only back home around 2 o'clock. So
no, that is not a problem.
And then I had to go back at 6.
No, that is not a problem. But I won't.
No. It's my problem. I should have done more. But and 1 and 2 I didn't do because I thought that since you had done that login, that was test case 1 and 2, so that's why I started by 3. But because when
but
you
that were, was, but that was in my sheet, right? You must have started with the number 1, right? The number.
Oh yeah, that is true. I should have done that. But I thought probably 1 or 2 I left. Here, one thing I also in the email I wrote it down. One thing I couldn't figure out what to do. Where it says input data and test data, I don't know what to. What should I put over there? So that's why I have left that column empty.
Okay, let me just see to the things. Okay, I will mute you and we'll see to the things, and side by side I will also give my comments on to the things. Okay, so firstly, it should be like, since this is the first test case for you. Okay, so the number should be proper. To test the functionality of the personal details fields. Sorry, personal detail fields? What are the personal detail fields? Personal details itself is a module in itself, right? It's a complete module, or you can say it's a page. Okay, so to test the functionality of personal detail fields. No, this word is not proper, Kumar. It should be like what are you actually testing in this? Let me read to the test case. So your precondition is the user should be logged in as the ESS user. Okay, the ESS user should be able to enter the first name. Okay, so you are actually checking that whether the person who is entering into the application, okay, if a ESS user is entering into the application, then is he able to enter the first name, or like he's entered to like he's able to enter anything into the fields or not, right? This is what you're trying to check in this test case, if I've got it correctly. Yes, okay. So now for that, what you will have to write is you are not checking the functionality of the personal detail fields. Okay, this is not the functionality first of all of this personal detail fields, and if you are writing it in this way, then you will have to write it down in more precise format, like you are checking only for the first name over here, right? So it should be like to test the functionality of the personal detail first name field. But this is also a very incorrect manner to write it. So what we are actually checking is whether a person is able to write anything into the first name text box. So we are checking that whether that first name text box is enabled or it is in the editable format or not. Okay, whether we are able to type or write anything, we are able to edit anything onto that or not. Okay, so this is our expectation and this is what we want to test in this particular test case. So the thing would be to test the editability. Editability of the text boxes in personal details form or in personal details page. Okay. Okay, Kumar, are you able to get this thing? Why I modified? Okay. Then the user should be logged in as ESS user. Okay, this is your precondition. And remember one more thing. See, in the steps you have written that the ESS user should be able to enter the first name. See, whenever you are writing the steps. Steps means what? You are giving the commands, a sort of command you are giving. Okay, whoever will be executing your test case. Okay, so you are giving some commands to the person whosoever will be executing your test case. So these are the types of commands which we are giving. So the commands should not contain the word should. Okay, if you are commanding it means the person has to do it. Okay, then you are not supposed to use the word should. Okay, so the thing would be the ESS user will should be able to enter. No, it should not be like this. It should be like the ESS user will type the name in the first name text box. Okay, now what name do you want the ESS user should type? So that name, that whatever you want to give the data in the test, like in the first name text box, that data you have to give over here. Suppose say I want some name as John. Okay, then this should be my test data or the data that I want to enter. Okay, as I told you that this data, it will be given to you, the dummy data would be prepared, okay, and it would be handed over to you. So the data which is present over there in the document, you have to take that data. Okay, so for now, since we don't have any document with us, so we'll assume any of the names, okay, or any of the data. And then your expected result. Okay, so what you have written in the expected result is the first name should appear in the first name box of the application. Okay, this is what you expect from the things. That's correct. Then after that, see, after that you have written some two more things over here. These are two different test cases that you are trying to check. Okay, so it should be given different test case ID. Okay, remember the thing that your test cases should be independent of each other, because suppose say like up till this point the test cases were given to some other tester, and from this test case it is given to some new tester, okay, to test. Then what he is going to understand, that there is nothing in the description, there is nothing in the precondition. How is he going to do the things? Where is that middle name text box? I don't know. And who is the ESS user? How is he logged in into the application? So your test cases should not be dependent on each other. Okay, so this should be a different test case ID. Okay, then after that, whatever description you want to give, what is the precondition, and then the steps to be taken. And again, see to the things that you are not using the word should over here. Yes, Pachay, I got your test cases. Okay, and Manju, will you please show the login page and the fields available? Okay, let me tell you that the application, it somewhat looks like this. Okay, we have discussed earlier, so for the new people who are present, let me just give you a very brief introduction about the application. See, this application is for the human resource management people. Okay, and this is used by, basically we are testing it for basically two types of users. Okay, the admin users who have all the control of the application. Okay, they can modify, they can delete, they can add any of the things. Okay, and then the second user who is using this application is the ESS user. Okay, now this ESS user is who are they fall into the category of the people who are newly joined into the company. Okay, so if any new employee is getting enrolled into the company, so his ID and his information needs to be stored in the database. Okay, and that works needs to be done by the HR people. Okay, so the person or the group of people who would be entering into the application, who would be adding this employee, who would be creating his ID and password, those people are the admin people. Okay, and the second set of people are the ESS user, that is the normal employees who are getting added into the application. Now the admin people, they will, though they will add the employee into the they will add the employee into the organization, they will create their IDs and everything, but while writing down their data, what they will do, they will only fill up the mandatory fields or the important required fields. Okay, and they will tell the new employee, okay, so I have created your ID and password. Now what you can do is you can just log in into the application by your own, since you have your ID and password, and then you can add the remaining, your remaining information. Okay, and what are the remaining information? These are the modules, or these are the forms that they have to fill. In each and every form, there are certain fields which are not to be edited by the ESS users, okay, or the employees. The editing on those fields or the modification on those fields could be done only by the admin people or the HR people. So over here in this personal details form, we have five fields like this, which could not be edited by the normal employees. So these details or these fields are the employee IDs, the SSN number, the SIN number, the driver license number, and the date of birth. Okay, so these fields are mandatory to be filled by the admin. Okay, and once they are filled by the admin, the ESS user, though he can see the fields over here and the data in that, but he cannot edit it if he wants to. Okay, whereas for the other fields, if the other fields are also filled by the admin people, and now if he feels that he has to change the address, or if he has shifted, okay, or if his marital status has changed, so he can change the things. But for these fields, he cannot change any of the things. He cannot do any of the modifications. Okay? Clear, Manju? Okay. And Kumar, are you also clear with the modifications that I'm trying to say? Let me unmute you. Hey, Kumar.
Yes, ma'am. I understand because yesterday, whenever the last class we had it, I basically understood. But what you are saying, it's making more sense right now. For example, you say you should not use the word "should do that." This is a command because I'm right. Somebody is writing to go and test an application, and this is a command: do this, and you will get that. You know.
Exactly.
So,
this is the command that we are giving. Okay, should would be the word that has to be used in the expected result column only. Okay, because this is what we are expecting from the application. We don't know how it would react when actually we would work onto that application. Okay, so we would use this word should over here in this column, that we believe that it should work in this way. Okay, though we are not we don't have the application with us, we can't test, we are not testing onto that application, we are just writing down the test cases. So this is what our expectation is. So the should word would be coming up over here. Okay, so Kumar, now can you do the modifications and can go ahead with the things? Are we clear with your things? Hey, Kumar.
That's good. You want me to do it and submit to you today, right now, or after the class?
No, not today or right now. I mean, you understood what I tried to.
Yes. What I'm going to do, end of the class, you know, before I finish my thing, I will have this thing mailed to you tonight. So whenever you get a chance tomorrow, you just can have a look. I will be really appreciate.
Okay. Yeah. Okay. I'll do that. You can mail me the thing. Not a problem. And Kumar, please try to. I have also done it from my part. Okay, so then after Kumar, let us move on. Okay, so I have got it for Sojanya. Then Sajanya, are you there? Is this your test case? I mean, is this your sheet? Because okay, so here it is, right? So your test case ID is TC underscore login underscore 01. Check the login page. Okay. Okay. The steps, enter the user ID, enter the password, click on the login button. Okay. Valid, what is that valid username and password that you need to give? Okay, Sajanya. So it should take to Orange HRM. We are already in Orange HRM, right? The login page is also for Orange HRM only. It should take us, or it should not to the Orange HRM, it should take us to the personal details form. Okay, because the login page is also of Orange HRM only, so we can't say that it should take us to Orange HRM. Now for the second thing, second test case, again for the login page, entering the ID password. So Janya, see, according to the SRS that we have got, we don't know that what would be the invalid password, right? Since you have written over here in the test data that we would give some invalid password. But over there, there is no requirement given that what should go inside that password text box. Okay, whether it should accept characters or alphanumeric or special characters or what should be the range and anything. So it is not anywhere specified in the document. So if you are entering the password, like this won't do. Okay. Or if you have written it in this way that you enter the user ID and then directly click on the login button. So that would be fine. This means that you are not entering anything in the password text box. So automatically, yes, that would be invalid. Okay. But over here, if you are typing any invalid password, we don't have the requirement document for the invalid text box. So we can't prepare the data that what is the invalid password would be. What it could be. Okay, so your expected result says that an error message should be displayed and the user should not be able to log in to the Orange HRM successfully. Okay, okay, this is fine. Okay, then you are going on to the personal details form to check the following fields are disabled while entering the personal details. Personal details. Okay, so the user has logged in and open. Okay, rather it should be the personal detail page is opened. Okay, then click on the following fields. Okay. That is SSN, driver license number, SIN, employee ID, driver. This is 2 times. Then the date of birth. Okay. These fields are gray out and cannot be modified. See, the test case is correct, but you could have written it down in a in a different way, because this does not look very much appropriate. Though your test case is right that you are checking that these fields should not be in the editable format, right? So check the following fields are while entering the personal details. What following fields are we going to check? So those following fields are over here. Okay, so over here it would be like to check. Check that the not the mandatory also that the okay, we can use the term mandatory, that the mandatory fields are disabled, but we don't need to write about this, that while entering the personal details, because anyhow if we are writing the test case ID, if you are writing in the test case ID like it is for the personal details, this means that you are checking for the personal details forms also. Okay, so this thing is optional, I would say. Okay, if you want to write, this is not required, but if you are writing, it is not wrong also. Okay, then the ESS user is logged in and the personal detail page is open. Okay, try on the click on the following fields. So these all are the fields. Okay, these fields are gray out and they cannot be modified. They cannot be edited. Okay. Okay. Then the personal details, you are checking for the save functionality. To check the save button, to check the functionality of save button. Okay, not to check the save button. The user is logged in and personal detail form detail page is opened. Okay, now click on the personal detail. Fill all the required information. Click on, why click on personal detail? If you are saying that personal detail page is open, then why click on personal detail again? Again the same page will be reloaded, right? So we don't require this step. And see, we cannot write it like this, that fill all the required information. We have to like write it down for each and every field. Okay, that we have to enter the license expiry date. Okay, then enter the gender, enter the nationality, enter the marital status. Okay, this would date of birth is already entered. Okay, then after that enter the nickname, enter the military service, then check the checkbox if you have to. Okay, and then click on the save button. Okay, so what all fields are present, you have to like write it explicitly over here, and then in the test data over here you have to give that whatever information you write, have to write down in the fields that you are asking the tester to test. Okay, so the data would be coming over here for that. You have not written about the edit text box. No one has written up, like neither Kumar, like I have checked only two up till now, but I didn't see any. See this, have you all read the SRS very carefully? See over here, directly the save button would not be present. Okay, it is written somewhere, I couldn't find it out right now. See, as it is over here for the contact details, it is written that click on edit to enter the information. Okay, so firstly over here, when you are opening any of the pages like either the personal details or the contact details or the immigration dependents, anything. So firstly, when you are opening any of these pages, the edit box would be present. Okay, once you click on that edit box, these fields will come into the editable mode. Okay, and then you can type down anything that the required data is typed over here. Okay. And once you have clicked on to the edit text box, only then you are able to write down anything, okay, over here in the text boxes. And as soon as you are clicking on the edit text box, it is getting converted to save. Okay, so like if you are clicking on to edit, if you are not clicking on to edit text box, until that time you won't be able to write anything also in the text boxes. Okay, so Jenny is saying that it's present over here. Okay, but don't you think so that before checking for the save, then we should check for edit first, because we would be able to check the save functionality only when we are editing the things, right? Okay, so the next is the personal detail modification with the valid values. Huh? Valid values first name means? Check the field on the personal information, then change the field first name with enter valid new name in this field means. I'm not able to understand this particular test case, Sojanya. Should I unmute you so that you can explain me? What have you tried to do over here? Yes, Arjuna.
Hello, Vidya.
Yeah, hi.
Hi. I just want to say that we can change the name in the name box actually. Whenever we need
Means you are trying to say that you can edit the name, right?
Yeah, it's like that only, yeah.
Okay, so instead of writing it in such a complex manner, you should have written it. Like we could to check the editability of the first name text box, right? Okay, if you are trying to say that you're checking or you're testing for the first name text box over there, that we are trying, if we are trying to enter different names in the first name text box, it's just taking that we are editing. So that could be. Editability of the first name text box. Okay, Orange HRM has been opened. See, if Orange HRM is open, this means that the login page is in front of you, because that is also Orange HRM. Okay, so over here, according to the steps that you are writing down over here, I can see that you are trying to say that the user should be logged in into the application, right? So over here it should be the ESS user is logged in the application. Okay, so check the field on the personal information. This is something which I could not understand. But what to check the field? So Jenny, can you explain this step? Let me unmute you. Hey, so Jenny. Hey Sajanya, are you there? Okay, Sajanya, I'm not able to hear anything back from you. But this is the step that actually I'm not able to understand. What are you trying to say? That check the field on the personal information. Then this is something, these steps I'm not able to understand. So either explain it to me in the chat box. Okay, or let me try to unmute you again. Hey Saujani, are you there?
Hello.
Hey, hi Saujani.
Hello Vidya.
Yeah.
Hi, hello Vidya.
Yeah, I'm here.
Yeah, the same thing I told you, right? So maybe I written something wrong, I don't know, but yeah, the same thing I want to say, that I need to check the first name, like.
So for this, see, see, it's very simple, Sajanya. If you want to check for the first name text box, then what should be the commands that you should be giving? That the person should, like, if he's entered into the application already, this means that the personal detail form is open in front of him or her, okay? Then the next command for the tester that you should be giving would be that he would be able to click onto that first name text box, right? And then he should try to write something on that if he wants to check the editability, correct? So it should be like very much simple, that click on the first name text box. Okay, and the second thing would be, the second step would be enter the data in the first name text box. Right? Don't you think so? Correct? And whatever is the data that you want to enter in that text box, you can give this data over here. Okay? And see, my expected result, what should be the expected result in that case then? What do you think would be the expected result? Yes, any one of you? If the personal detail form is opened, okay, in front of an ESS user, and he is trying to type anything in the first name text box, then what should happen? Manju, you are saying that it should change to edit page. No, but you have not changed the personal detail form first into the editable mode, right? So if you are trying to edit anything over there, firstly it should not allow you to edit. Okay. So it should not allow the user to edit the things. Firstly, if the user has to edit on any of the things, then he should first enter the click on that edit text box. Okay. So whatever data, suppose say you are giving over here A, B, C, D, anything. Okay. Then my expected result for this test case would be, user should not be allowed to edit anything. Yes, Pache, the fields apart from the five mentioned fields over there, they are editable, but only if you have clicked onto the edit text box, edit button. Okay. So for that, first you need to click on the edit button. to open the form in the editable mode. Okay, so if you are opening the form in the editable mode, then also the fields which are restricted from a normal user to be edited, those fields won't be in the editable format. Yes, the other fields, they would be converted into the editable format. Okay, this is what I want to tell you. Okay, so Saujanya, can you do the changes? And one more thing, try to like, I told you that you should keep all the steps of a particular test case in one column only. Okay, so make sure that you are presenting it in a proper manner. Okay, because the person won't be able to understand that where the steps are going. Okay, so just try to keep it in a proper format, and you can edit the other test cases also, right? And if you have any problem, just mail it to me, I will review it for you. Okay, now after Saujanya, I guess who was sending me the email? I guess it was Anuja. Let me see. Okay, is Anuja here? No, Anuja has gone offline. So when she'll come back, we'll review her test cases. Kavita Sam. Okay, so these are your test cases. Okay, so you have taken the version number. That's okay. Then verify the orange HRM application. The application is installed on the computer. Okay. Click on the website link. Close the application manually, entering the website name in the browser window. Okay. For each of the steps you have written the expected result over here. Okay, this could also be done, not an incorrect way to do the things. So which the website should get closed manually entering. Okay, so we are checking that whether if we are trying to open it manually it is getting opened or not. Okay, then verify user interface. Application verify user interface of that. The website name with the logo of Orange HRM should be at the top left side of the application form. Okay, the open source HR management should be at the bottom of the logo. Okay, the second orange logo should be at the okay, so you have taken all those expected results like by viewing the application. That is good enough. That is good. This part is good. And the login button should be present in the login panel, bottom of that. Okay. And verify the name and this is to verify the name and password. No, you are not verifying the name and password. You are verifying the login button, that whether the login button is functioning properly or not, right? You are verifying that thing. Okay, so this is to verify the functionality of login button. Okay, so enter the valid username, enter valid password, then click on the login button. And okay, this is correct, but make it in steps. That would be like more easy to catch. Okay, it's the only thing. And over here you need to write down the test data, that what you would be entering in the username and what is the thing that you are entering in the password. Okay, then the application should be, sorry, the application should display the home page. See, the application should display the home page, that is okay, but apart from that, the main functionality of, or what we expect if we are giving any username and password, we expect that we are getting entered into the application. Okay, so this is the main motive of performing this test case or this test. Okay, so you can write this also, but you need to add the application should display the home page, and also okay, so are you trying to say that the home page will be displayed only when the person is getting logged in into the application? Like, so this directly or indirectly means that the person is getting logged in into the application. Am I correct? Yes, Kavita. Okay. Okay, then you can leave it. Then verify invalid. See, the description, I'm not satisfied with the description part that you are mentioning. Verify invalid username and verify invalid password. How are you going to verify the invalid username and password? Log out and log in with the valid username and invalid. Now, why log out? Why log out from the application? You are trying to say that we were, from the previous test case, we were logged in into the application. This is why we need to first log out. Yes, Kavita. Oh, see, you don't have to consider the previous test case that you have written. Okay, each test case, whatever you are writing, it should be independent on its own. It should not be dependent on the previous one. Okay. Again, I would be giving you the same example, that suppose say your first three test cases are given to tester one. Okay. And from the fourth test case, it is given to some other tester, tester two in your team. Okay, some XYZ tester, and some three test cases which you have written earlier, okay, up till this point, they were given to some ABC tester. So he knows that you are entered into the application. Now from here, XYZ, how does he know that logout means? He would be confused that I'm not logged in into the application, how would I log out? Okay, so your test cases should not be dependent on each other, because randomly they would be distributed for execution to any of the testers, and you don't know that whether the previous test case that you are written or you are depending upon would be given to the same tester or not. Okay, and also sometimes your clients also want to see the test cases, that how you are doing the testing. Okay, so if he has a technical team, if the client also has a technical team, then he will send the technical team sometimes, or he may randomly ask you that, show me your test cases. I would randomly pick up any of the test case and would execute it. So what if he has taken the fourth test case? Okay, you got my point? Yes, Anuja, I saw that you were offline, so this is the reason I put you on hold. Okay, so I'm doing for Kavita. I called out your name, but you were not there. So let me just finish with Kavita. I'm almost done, and then we can do yours. Okay. Okay, so I guess I'm clear with this now that we don't have to take the logout. Now you have to log in with the valid username and the invalid password. See, again I would say that steps would be in the step format only. Okay, don't make it like in a description way. Okay, so it would be better if you write it in the steps, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and the following. Okay, so despite of this, you can write it down like enter the username, enter the password, and then click on the login button. And over here in the data, you can give it like what is the username that you want to give. This is the username that I want to give, okay. For the password you want that it should be blank. Invalid password, I told you that we don't have the requirement document for the text boxes, so we can't test for those things. So if you then also want to test it, then this would be a part of invalid only. Okay, this is only that we could get. So password, leave it blank. Nothing should be written in the password. So it is a part of the invalid only. You can then click on the login button. So for that you are saying that the application should display the error message and reopen the login page. Okay, that's correct. Okay, I'm satisfied with the other things, but for the description part you need to work upon this. Okay, and also though you are writing the steps correctly, the steps are correct, I am not saying the steps are wrong, but make sure that or try to write down your steps in the step format only. Okay, in spite of the paragraph format and anything. Okay, so because the column name we are giving it as steps, it's not a paragraph that we have to write. Okay, and write the things in the input data, put the data. Okay, Kavita, else it is good. Okay. Okay, now we can take for Anuja. So Anuja, this is your test cases. Okay. For login, to test the functionality of the login button, enter the username, password, login button, data. Okay. Then for the personal details, to test the functionality of the save button in the personal detail forms. The precondition is the user is logged in as the ESS user. Okay. Then enter all the details of the ESS user except the restricted fields. See, this is for Anuja, right? Yes, Anuja, I just explained, I don't know whether you were there or you went offline, that you have to write the name of the fields that you have to enter the data into. Okay, explicitly you have to mention the name of all the fields. Okay, like the name of the fields were the first name, the middle name, the last name. Okay, where it is. Okay, so don't write about the employer ID and the restricted fields, other issues. But for the other fields, you'll have to explicitly write it down in the steps that click on the full name, okay, then click on the middle name, click on the last name and enter the data. Then click on the gender boxes. Then this is also, okay, this can also be filled by the ESS user. So then click on the license expiry date, enter the data. So for everything you have to write it down. Like don't mention the restricted fields as you have written over here, but you need to mention the other fields, and then you have to click on the same button, save button. Okay, so while if you're writing for all the fields, so you have to write the data also over here, okay, whatever data you are entering, so that would come over here in the test data. All entered details are to be displayed and saved. Okay, not to forget, again I'm saying that before checking the functionality of the save button, see, you must have seen in the contact details. This is the reason I told you that read the contact details also along with the personal details, because over there it is written that the form would be, when you are opening a form, it is not in the editable format. You have to first go and click on the edit button, okay, which would then save into the which would then convert into the save button. Okay, so if I am like getting logged in into the application, a personal detail form is open in front of me, okay, then this does not mean that I am able to edit the non-restricted fields on my own. Okay, firstly there would be a edit button present over here which you need to enter, which you need to click, then only the non-restricted fields would be converted into the editable format. Okay, until and unless you have clicked onto the edit button, the non-restricted fields would also be not in the editable format. Okay, so you need to write for that also. Then in personal details, verify the restricted fields. Okay. User tries to edit any of the following fields. Okay, he should not be able to enter any of the data to the specified fields. Okay. Okay, this is good. Then in the personal details, to verify the add button. The user is on the personal details page. No attachment is uploaded. Okay, click on the add button. Uploaded. Okay, data. If you are clicking on the add button, then after that what you need to do? See, if I am the tester, okay, who is executing this test case, okay, so what I will understand and what I will do is I will go to the personal detail page as an ESS user, okay, I will log in into the application and the personal detail page will be opened in front of me, and I will make sure that no attachment is uploaded, okay, before checking. Then I will click on the add button as you have said. Now clicking onto the add button, does it make, like if I'm just clicking on the add button, am I getting the uploaded image or anything is uploaded over there just by clicking onto the add button, do you think so? Yes, you need to select an attachment, right? So this should also go under your steps, right? That after clicking, this would be the first step undoubtedly. Then after that, the second step would be select the image that you want to upload. Okay, and which should be of the size which is mentioned. Okay, clear with this thing, Anuja? So can you do the modifications and the updations in this one? In the other also? Are you able to understand? Okay, these were pretty good. Okay, so now I have received. Okay, I'm left with Tasneem, Saqib, Pachai, Kathy, and okay, these four. So we will be doing this in the next session now. Okay, I will be reviewing these test cases in the next session now. That is tomorrow. Yes, Anuja, after the updations you can mail it to me, not a problem. Samatha, oh, have you sent me before? When? Samatha, oh. Yes, I have, yes, Samatha, I replied you black also, right? Yeah, these were also good test cases. Oops. I have seen these test cases. So error message should be shown as password field cannot be empty. Yes, Samatha, I totally forgot about that. Okay. Yes, since I have seen it earlier, so it won't take much time now to just go through it again. So for the login, they were good to this. Then for the names, it is the functionality of the name field. See, up till login it was perfect. Now over here you are actually, while you are writing down the steps, what you are saying that you need to enter the first name, the middle name, last name, and then click on the save button. So actually what you are doing, you are checking the functionality of the save button. Okay, and like from the steps I could understand this thing. And whereas your expected result is saying that user should be able to enter the name successfully and go to the next field. Okay, so over here you should not write it as click on the save button. You are only checking that whether you are able to enter the data in the various fields or not, right? This is what you're trying to do. Yes, okay. So it should be not the functionality, testing. So you're checking the editability of the fields. Okay, so are you particularly checking for one field or are you checking for n number of fields? Because over here you are switching on to different fields. That is the first name, middle name, and the last name. You can't like combine all those fields into the name. Okay, because these are separately, like they have their separate names. So it would be to test the editability of, if you want to check for all three of them in one test case, see, either I would suggest you that check the editability of all the fields, okay, of all the non-restricted fields. Okay, or just check for one field. So if you are checking for all the non-restricted fields, then you'll have to write down like enter the first name, middle name, or what else are the other non-restricted fields apart from this. Yes, Samantha, you can ask your question. You want me to unmute you? But then your let me just complete with this thing and then I would unmute you. So if you are checking the editability of these things, then you should not be able to enter. Right? As I told you that though the person is logged in into the application with the form open in front of him, okay, but in the initial phase, until and unless you click on the edit button, it won't be in the editable format, not the non-restricted fields also. Okay, so your expected result is not correct over here. Now let me just unmute you. Samantha, right?
Hi, Vidya. Here I'm testing the name field by giving all the three names correctly. And the next thing is I'm giving the first name and the last name should be mandatory. They are star. So I'm skipping the last name and giving the first name and middle name. The second one is.
Okay. In the other
one. I'm just testing the name field here. How it is accepting the names. Whether it is accepting the one name or two names. The first name and last name are mandatory, so I have to give them for sure. So I'm just testing it without giving the first name once and without giving the last name.
See, the 6 and the 7 are correct in that way if you are testing that since the first name and the last name are mandatory. So these are correct.
Yeah, for the first time I'm testing by giving all the names correctly. All the names, three names.
Yes, but the point that I am trying to explain you is you cannot enter any of the fields only until you have clicked onto the edit button.
But there is no edit button there in the first personal details. I don't know whether I missed it or not. I have to check it again once again.
I actually don't remember exactly about where it is present in the personal details or whether it is present in the personal details or not. Okay, but
no,
It might not be present. I'm not so sure about it. But since it is present in the contact details and every form is like the contact detail, the personal details, they all are coded in the same way. So we have to take it like that every form is in the same format.
Okay.
So this is one thing which is not explicitly said in the requirement document, and I feel that this is one of the defect of the document only, that it should be explained over here in the personal. Okay, so I guess in the last session I missed this thing, so this is why in this session I first explained this thing, okay, and then I told you that over here you have to do the changes. Okay, Samantha?
Okay, yeah.
Okay, else your test cases were good enough. So based upon the new thing that I told you, you have to modify this thing, that like the personal details only, anything won't be editable only if you have clicked, until and unless you have clicked on the edit button. Okay. And for the others, I will review your test cases in the next session, that is tomorrow, and all those people who were new to the bash today, Manju, let me unmute you. Hey, Manju.
Yeah, are you able to hear me?
Yeah, I can.
Yeah, actually what my doubt is, you are telling that there will be some edit button, and if you click on the edit button, then it will allow the user to enter into the field names like first name, middle name and all. So in such a case, so first of all, we look into the login page, how we can write the test cases. Like first of all, we write test case for the edit button, like edit button is there, the user should enter edit, click on the edit button. Mm-hmm. Then what is the scenario? So it will allow the user to enable to enter the data, and after that check the first name field. So enter the data in the first name and like some sample data, and so it will allow the user to change the field and click on save. After that for the first name field you just check for it is allowing the user to enter the first name field. After that, middle name entry, it is allowing the user to enter the middle name, the last name, it is allowing the user to enter the last name. Yeah. And after that for the save button test case, you just write the test case for save, and enter that, click on the save to save the already entered fields. This is the case, or before that we have to check for all the fields, because before